Hello, Congressman King. Thanks so much for joining me today. I know it's a busy day for you. The way I read the coverage on you, and it comes from so many different angles, but it seems to be very similar, is that you just may be one of the guys that's fomenting a revolt against what's going on right now and getting members of the Republican Party to come on side with you and blink and just go for it and pass the CR, pass the resolution with no strings attached and move on. Is this true? And if so, how many people you got with you?
Actually, basically, I consider myself a solid conservative, but I think what's happened here with the Ted Cruz Republicans is absolute insanity. We've allowed them to hijack our party, and there's any number of people in our party, you know, they call themselves moderates or whatever, who say this is wrong and we have to have a clean continuing resolution and the government has to be reopened. But the fact is, we have to take action. It's not good enough to talk about it. One thing I have to give Ted Cruz acolytes credit for is when they want to do something, they just do it. Now, I've been voting no for the last, really ever since Monday night, saying that we just have to go forward and we have to stop all this delaying, we have to stop all of this government shutdown talk, but we have to take action. Unless we take firm action, John Boehner is going to be stuck with the Ted Cruz Republicans. I have a great regard for John Boehner. I think he does not want to be in this position, but the Cruz Republicans have put him there, and if people who are opposed to that want to show they're serious, they have to start taking action.
So I'm still trying to read into the numbers here. And from what I've seen, you've mentioned that you had a meeting yesterday. You think there's about 10 members at this point who believe that they really do want to go ahead with a clean resolution, no strings attached, and get the government back open. These are Republicans. But that you secretly believe it's closer to 24, and that if you had an anonymous vote tomorrow, you'd have 180 Republicans who would vote for a clean resolution. So how does that play when the speaker invites people of your ilk into a meeting yesterday? Was he angry with you? Did he respect the fact that you and a growing number of Republicans want to do this? What was that meeting like?
Well, basically, again, you know, it's a private meeting. I don't want to give anything away other than to say there was at least 10 people at that meeting, and there's another 15 or so who agree, were willing to go openly and say the government should reopen. But the reluctance is to take action now to force that. I'm saying we have to force it now, because otherwise this is going to go on until next week. And every day that we're delaying, as 800,000 people are out of work, the service is being denied, our national security is at risk. So really, again, the difference is the Cruz Republicans, they take action. They don't care what anyone thinks of them. I think too many of the moderates right now seem to be reluctant to take that step. I understand that they, you know, feel maybe it's too quick, but I'm saying if the government is shut down, we can't wait any longer. So I'm urging that we take quicker action. Others think that it's better if we wait a few days. Whatever it is, it's only a matter of time before the government reopens. So if that's the case, let's do it now. Let's not allow these Cruz people to have this stranglehold over the Republican Party and over the country.